Well, this been a while, like a whole 3 months or so, but I'm back. A couple reasons why I've been gone. I quit my job. Honestly, I was being mistreated there, so I didn't want to stick around anymore, so I decided to leave. And, well, now I'm jobless. I was supposed to make money so I can buy more car parts, but yeah, that didn't fall through because of Christmas and a whole bunch of other things. I'm here with another video because, well, I have an idea. Probably gonna be the worst idea. Probably can't go back after it, maybe. I am going to test using this nail polish on my wheels. And to be more specific about it, I am going to be using it for my rivets that's on my wheels. But before I do that, I am going to test it because I believe this valve stem is the same material as the rivets. I mean, it feels the same in my opinion, so I am going to test this. And if it looks good, I am going to apply it on. Hopefully this is a good idea. Kind of. It's kind of blotchy. It's easier to paint it, if you know what I mean. Like, actually using a spray can, but there is no possible way for me to do this. So as I can see, it doesn't look too bad. As long as it dries up, it actually doesn't look too bad. I'll explain more like why I decided to do this and with a nail polish instead of trying to take out those rivets when I pull my car in. Try to pull in here at least because it's actually cold outside. Because I don't have the space. I mean, on one side I do, but sort of. I just roll with it as of right now. If anything, I'll just pull it out. But, alright. As I can continue, let me explain why I am going to be trying to use nail polish on my rivets. Alright. So, as you can see, these rivets and my valve stem is gold. So, I'm kind of over of the gold look on my rivets. And so these rivets, there's nothing on the other side of these wheels because these are, I would just say, rep wheels. They're not like the real wheels, like Workmeisters or anything. So these are just plastic. They're not metal. So I can't take these off without damaging it. And if I damage it, I have to replace it. I already tried. I never put it on any video because I was just like, I was going to test it out because I seen one guy did it. I'll put it in his video in the description if you ever want to try it. But for me, I think I might have to try it this way because I don't have any other options on how to get these painted. Plus, what he did is a lot more work than what I'm going to be doing, but I mean, it's just to attempt it.
Wow, that light is something else right now. But anyway, I am just trying to attempt it. I'm no means like know what I'm doing. But I mean, like, if some people is able to use nail polish to repair like the edge of the wheel, don't mind this. This is like curb before, and then I repaired it on like within 5 minutes, so don't mind that. What was I saying? Oh yeah, if people were able to repair wheels with nail polish, why can't I paint it with rivets? And I already know a lot of you are going to be complaining about me doing it this way instead of just like, oh, why would you just buy new wheels? As I said in the beginning of the video, I don't have a job. I don't have the money to be buying new wheels. I can, but I'm not willing to because I have future plans with this car. And it's not falling through as of right now because I don't have the funds. So this is my temporary solution to painting my rivets wheels. Just paint it, basically. Anyway, I'm gonna give it a try and hopefully it goes well. I got my alcohol. Well, it says glass cleaner, but it's labeled as alcohol because my mom decided to put it in this bottle. But what I'm going to be doing now is spraying all these little rivets because I know that it's covered in brake dust. As you can see around the wheel, it's covered in brake dust. So I am going to spray all the rivets and I'm going to wipe it down and then I'm going to get started painting. Hopefully this works. Alright, since I already sprayed down the whole entire rivets, so I'm gonna wait for it to dry. It shouldn't take that long since alcohol evaporates pretty fast, so probably just about 1-2 minutes and then I'm gonna get started spraying. So I'm gonna
Within that time, I'm just going to shake up the can and then spray it. Well, actually, I haven't shown you the can, so let me grab that. So I already know I'm going to get a lot of hate for this. So the little spray can that I'm going to be doing is this. So don't hate me, but I'm trying to go for a different look. All right, so I'm doing things on a budget rather than spending a whole bunch of money that I know a whole bunch of people would do. And if it turns out good, great. I don't want to spend like, how much is wheels? Probably like 600 plus. Then this tires. I'm doing this for 10 bucks. Well, then again, I wasted money on that. Well, I returned it, so basically 10 bucks. So I'm just gonna shake this up and I'm gonna get started. All right, it's time. Honestly, I'm a bit nervous because I have no idea how this is gonna turn out. And I really need two hands for this. Oh, this is scary. Well, luckily, it's just plastic dip. It's gonna be easy to clean off. It's just kind of a hassle, but if anything, if it doesn't look that good, then I'm just gonna scrap the whole entire idea and just probably invest in new wheels. Something I don't have money for, but it looks like I gotta save up for it now, even though I want other things. Fuck. Okay, so after I think I did 4 coats. Yeah, I did 4 coats. After four coats, it's not that bad from far away. It's pretty bad up close. It's best if I just show you. Look at that. It looks good far away. Here, let's get up close. There's some gold that's showing. There's some, if it focus, it doesn't show the black, but there's a little black there that you can see. It's not, for some reason, it's not covering that. But honestly, it does not look that bad from far away. Oh, I need to touch up on that. What the hell? Far away, doesn't look that bad. And don't worry about the valve stem caps. I'm gonna do the same thing. Doesn't look that bad from far away. So my initial thoughts on this, if you were to do this, if you're on the tight budget, I recommend doing it. But if you're like a professionist, I'm kinda am, I don't want to run these, but I mean, like, from far away, it doesn't look that bad, so I am going to run it. So it's just like, until I afford new wheels, then I'll do it. Because now I have an idea, like, what it would look like on black wheels. But if I somehow got polished wheels, I want to make these polished, but I feel like it's going to be a pain in the ass. But then again, it would look so nice. Other than that, do I recommend doing this? If you're on the budget, go ahead. But if, honestly, just get real wheels. Don't do what I'm doing, honestly. Just don't do it. So I am just gonna keep working on this, and I'm gonna do the rest of the wheels, and then I will show you the end result of it. Because I'm trying to keep my video short. I don't want to keep them long, mainly because I'm trying to finish this whole entire project in a day, and I really wasted enough time. I think it's like 1 o'clock and sun goes down like 5 already, so I need to get this finished. So I'll probably time lapse it, but if I don't time lapse it, then you're just gonna see the end result. So most likely you're gonna see the end result like as a who knows when. Most likely you just see the end result. So I'm just going to continue working on this, and plus I'm going to need to start peeling all this extra
classy yet. So, this is gonna be a waste of time. I finished, and well, it didn't turn out as what I thought it would look like. I mean, it, honestly, the best of my capabilities, but not bad for an amateur. Just get real ones. It just saves you the trouble and money, I guess. Unless you just buy all at once, but enough of me chit-chatting. This is gonna be the end of the video, so I'm just gonna cue the cinematics and I will see you guys in the next video, which is hopefully soon, because I am just waiting to see what this guy's response is. All right, peace.